Hey Cafe crew, it's Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe, and today I'm going to show you how to use layer blend modes inside of Photoshop. So this tutorial is well overdue. I've had quite a few requests for blend modes in Photoshop. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you what the different blend modes are. They're actually in different families. I'm going to explain that to you. And then I'm also going to show you how to use them. Now, there's a ton more information at Photoshop Cafe, including an ebook. I've created a free ebook on layer blend modes. So what I do is I actually give you an example of every single blend mode. I show you how it works. And then I'll give you a few examples for using blend modes. And I've got that for free. So just click that link underneath and grab that ebook right now. So let's just talk about blend modes. I'm going to give you a 20-second explanation, and then we're going to start with three different examples. So when we go in a layer, we see the blend layer on top, and there's another one underneath, so we can see that. See that layer is above it. And then we click on where it says normal, we see our blend modes. Now, to help you out, there's six different types or six different families of blend modes. The first two at the top are the normal modes, and the only thing that will change is the transparency. So dissolve will actually create a chalky effect. And let's go down a little bit here into the next mode. This is the darken mode. In the darken mode, the result darkens the image, but white becomes invisible. On the lighten modes, it's the opposite of the darken modes. With these, the result is lighter, like two projectors pointing at the same screen. And then what will happen is black becomes invisible on the top layer. So that's a way of hiding black. And then the fourth group right here is what's known as the contrast group. Contrast is increased between the two layers, and anything that's 50% gray is going to be hidden. So these are different ways of working to do things. Then we've got the comparative modes. These are more utilitarian, and these are great for comparing layers, for aligning them for different purposes. And then finally, we've got the color modes, and these will do different things with colors. So each one of these blending modes will enable us to do something different in Photoshop in the click of essentially just one click. All right, so let's have a look in this example here. We've got these two text files over this image. So here's a text file here. We've got the black versus the white. Now you could go and select the white and get rid of it, or you could use a layer blend mode. So let's just give you an example. We talked about these blend modes. So let's grab that white layer right there. And remember what we talked about, some of these blend modes, the darken blend modes at the top, they hide white. So if we choose that mode, look at this right away, we can see that we've got our black there and our white is hidden. Now darken is the first one, but actually multiply tends to work quite well. So go between multiply and darken to get the result, and you can see there it's perfectly hidden without any selections. Let's move up to the next one. We've got this white text with the black. We want to hide the black. We don't want to select and delete the black. It would take too long. So if you remember the blend modes, the second group of blend modes, yes, that's right, will hide that. So if we go down to lighten, it will hide black. And typically, screen works best for this one. And it just gives a cleaner result. So we can see that right there. All right, that's the first two blend modes. So let's move along to a different type of blend mode here. So here we've got this superhero image, and then here we've got this kind of cool effect here. So I'm just going to drag that into that layer and release, and it's going to put it on the top. So we want to create some kind of an effect. Now we could spend a lot of time selecting this, or we could go to the blend modes, and we could go into some of the middle ones. We could try these. See how the overlay, well, kind of makes it look a little dull. We want these brighter parts to show, so how are we going to do that? If we go up into the lighten modes, notice that we can see the lighten mode there. We can go to screen. We can go to color dodge, and we can try some of the different ones. Now, notice as we're clicking through them, we're seeing different results. Here's a quick little tip here. If you want to cycle through the blend modes, make sure you move the move tool. Choose the move tool. That's the V key. And then we can hit the shift and the plus key. And notice as we do this, now we can cycle through these different blend modes. And if we look there, the light and color actually cuts that out pretty good. And we can also get on and try some different modes here. So the shift plus or the shift minus will enable us to cycle through them. So right now I kind of like this one. I'm going to actually just hit control T, and we're going to flip this around just to kind of create a different type of effect here. Now, we can also refine these by using levels or curves. So what I'm going to do is select that layer and hit Control L for levels. And notice as I pull in the blacks here, notice how that will just clean up some of those edges. And of course, we can force the whites this way. See that? And the midtones here will also change how this blends between some of these different areas. See that? So we can do that as well. Now you could also mask out those little edges to create a slightly different effect. So let's just create a mask quickly. Grab a black brush, soft edge brush there, and we could just kind of, you know, blend these edges in if we wanted. So we don't want to have this harsh kind of blend there. So you can see that. And you could do all kinds of different things with this, you know, with these blend modes. But let's move on to the next blend mode. All right, so let's go here. And we have a woman here relaxing at the beach, but it doesn't look very warm. So why don't we create some kind of a flare or some kind of a sun effect? So what we're going to do is we're going to create a new layer. And with that new layer selected, we're going to grab yellow for the foreground. And we're going to grab our gradient tool. But what we're going to do is we're going to change our gradient tool here to show our foreground to transparent. So let's just grab that right now. And then we can just click and drag. And as we do that, notice we just add that yellow there. Now it's just a yellow gradient going over the top. So it's not really doing a lot of magic right now. But there are different things. If we just want the color, go down to color mode. Notice it will protect all the luminosity and we just change the color there. Doesn't necessarily create the best flare though. So other things that tend to work quite well could be the soft light is a good result. Look at that. See, that's kind of nice. Gives it a nice flavor. We could also try overlay. Notice that overlay blend mode is another one that works well. And we can also, you know, play around with opacity. We can reduce that as well. And then other ones that seem to work quite well for this sometimes is sometimes a color dodge can create a real bright flare. See that? Notice how it kind of changes the effect, and you could even put like a little lens flare or something in there. And then a screen mode could also work quite well. So just feel free to experiment with these blend modes here, and you can see how we get a different result using each blend mode.
So thanks for watching. If you want to become a cafe crew, hit that subscribe button right now. You'll get new tutorials every week. So that was layer blend modes. Don't forget, I've got a free ebook for you. Check it out there on that link. And that shows you an example of every single layer blend mode, how they work inside of Photoshop, and different examples of things that you can do inside of blend modes. So I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, add a like and add a comment. Let's get a discussion going. Let me know, because this actual tutorial was requested by a member. So why don't you make a request, and maybe I'll do your tutorial next week. We'll see. All right. Thanks, guys. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.